But then it's a very tough market. Right after I started, the COVID crisis happened. We saw, you know, we were really scared, but very fortunately what happened was that retail investor participation in the market really picked up. So we sort of started in the at the correct time for the digital audience, and we saw very good growth come in. And I think that is the massive opportunity that Indian markets are seeing right now. If you guys follow the market, the number of mutual fund investors, the number of demat accounts, that is rising at a rapid pace. The number of mutual fund investors is rising at a CAGR of 20%, right? Demat accounts are rising at a rate of 35% CAGR. And there's a massive opportunity out there, not just for investors, but also for investment professionals. Why this is happening is because of the strong growth that the Indian market is showing us. There are so many opportunities out there in the market. There are so many emerging industries. There are so many emerging. Indian market is expanding. And in an expanding market, if you're following a quantitative data-driven strategy, you can do quite a lot, right? So that's the opportunity we sort of bet on. And you know, it has worked really well for us. You know, we started from scratch, and right now, in the retail audience, we have more than 20,000 active paying investors who invest with our strategies. And we have actually done it at a very, very good, I mean, we've done really well for our clients. We have delivered more than 50% CAGR returns for a few of our strategies. So that speaks volumes about the opportunities that are out there and why people should actually come in and, you know, really take this seriously and make investing their long-term plan, right? I mean, I was just listening to the previous session and they were talking about going with investors, going with advisors and, you know, taking investing seriously. And I can, you know, tell you from my real experience that there's so many opportunities that it actually delivers if you are investing prudently with a, let's say, an advisor who's helping you, or with a quantitative or a robo advisor like us who can present, who does the research and presents you with these strategies, right? So I think that is what we've been doing amidst some notes. So I think, see, one is that massive opportunity, and then you have, I would like to speak to you guys about the promise of data-driven investing and quant investing. We've seen that, so at Wright Research, any decision that we take, right, where to invest, how to invest, how much to invest, I take it through a model, right? There is no decision that happens without the model coming out and telling us, right? And in this whole space, you know, we've all been listening and seeing about ChatGPT and all these AI engines come in. But if you look at investing as a field, that is the field that uses the most amount of data, right? Investing is in fact all about data, right? All the stock prices, the fundamentals, even the sentiments coming out from the news, all of it is available for you to play around with, you know, if you like looking at data, right? So that opportunity is huge. We at Wright Research, you know, obviously do everything in a systematic fashion. So, you know, if you think about an investor, what they do is they have a philosophy, right? That I'm going to maybe look at stocks, look at their valuations and bet on the stocks that are undervalued. What we would do is we would put that same strategy into a system. We put that whole thing into a system and then we would take it back across horizons, across different scenarios, analyze it and see, you know, how the system does and what we can do to improve it, right? That creates a sense of consistency into the system. Plus, it removes the, you know, subjectivity that an investor could have. If you are investing with a human investor, you know, if I was advising you, I could be biased. I would say, you know, I bought this stock with so much analysis, so I'm not going to sell it. Whereas a data-driven strategy would not have that bias, right? So with this, we are adding so much to the investor's life. We are able to look at a bunch of data sets. We are able to automate risk management and add so much value to the investor's life. And I think that is going to be the future of investing in India. If you guys look at the growth that the quant strategies are seeing, I mean, if you guys follow the market, you must be listening and hearing a lot about quant coming up, you know, one or the other fund launching a quant strategy. So I think, see, we are extremely positive about that, and there's so many opportunities for people to come in and invest into these strategies as new investors also. you know, people are scared that, you know, if I'm following an advisor, is he, will this be suitable for me or not? Is this guy taking a gambling bet in the market? Somebody, you know, people are scared about those aspects of the market. But if you're following a systematic method where there is no bias, I think that gives confidence to the new investor as well. And talking about data-driven methods and AI in investing, there are a couple of interesting use cases that I would like to talk to you guys about. First is, you know, the markets, you know, obviously go through a very, very good phase, a bull phase, where, you know, everybody is investing, everybody is very happy. But then they go through a bearish phase also, where there is risk. And, you know, whatever is working in a bull market does not work in a bear market. So what we do is we use AI models to forecast. We look at macroeconomic data and all of that to forecast what will happen in terms of risk. Another interesting use case we are seeing is, you know, all this news data that is coming out. If you, you know, a system like ChatGPT can analyze those news data and tell you what is the sentiment about this stock in the market, what is the, you know, is there a red flag that came out? So there's so many interesting opportunities about AI and investing that that are out there, which we are extremely passionate about. And I think having talked about that, let me also quickly walk you through, you know, my journey as a female entrepreneur, and you know, I'll conclude with that. So, you know, it's been quite a journey for me. I sort of started, like I said, from scratch, and wasn't taken very, very seriously. Was discounted for being a woman for a while, and I sort of started as a solo founder. Still, I'm a solo founder, and there was a lot of initially people would not take it seriously and all that, but along the way, I can tell you, you know, there are so many people who follow along with what we're doing. They really trust what we are offering, and they look for, you know, what our opinions or what how we can help them in their investing. I think that has been a tremendous journey. Recently, we've launched a portfolio management service also. We see this opportunity for the mass affluent segment also. See, we did it for retail for a while. Now we think that even the high net worth individuals, they also want quantitative strategy, so we launched something for them. And we're seeing extreme high interest coming from that segment as well. And people with serious appetite are trusting us to invest, and it's been an incredible journey. I think I've had to persevere a lot because, you know, financial markets, like the previous speaker was telling you, is highly regulated. So if you are going to follow the regulations, then there can be a number of challenges. So as an entrepreneur, I've seen regulations change, and, you know, suddenly the business is impacted, or you cannot run this thing or the other. And throughout all this, I think there's been a big learning on you know, persevering, being a little bit conservative if you're working in the market, because markets can move wildly. Trying to build a team, I think that's a huge challenge. I think keeping your eye on the ball and, you know, working towards the next target. And yeah, we're very happy about what you're doing, and would be very interested if, you know, anybody would have any questions about what we do, and would love to answer some of it.
How do you destigmatize this, especially in the Indian context? And did it take a bit of learning for you to do that as an entrepreneur?
Yes, no, definitely. See, I have never done fundamental investing. I've always been data-driven, right? So since 2011, I've been working in quantitative and algo trading. And I'll tell you, you know, like 6-8 years ago, when I used to work in these large corporations, and we would talk to people about quant investing, data-driven investing, people would just laugh at it. That doesn't work in India. You know, we don't think this is something, it's a system, what will it do and all of that. Now, on the other hand, you know, the new age of investors who are coming into the market, right? If you look at it, if I look at my audience, I would see so many people coming from, you know, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Mumbai, who are technically aware, like who know, who are probably coming from tech backgrounds only, and they understand if you're talking in terms of data and statistics, right? Like even for me, if somebody is selling me something, I would love if they gave me some numbers. So I think that is the change that is happening, that the new investors coming in actually like that. And you know, having done that, we have also built a level of trust. We have done very good risk management. You know, in times of risk, we have done well. We also delivered good returns. So I think people are slowly adapting towards it. We are not the biggest guys out there, but we are slowly seeing some adaption. Yeah.
What's your AUM like? And you can also talk about your investment fundraise and all that.
Yeah, yeah. So so for the retail folks, we advise on close to 600 crores. Across 20,000 people, and for the HNI audience, we have just crossed 100 crore ka benchmark number. I posted on LinkedIn. I got a crazy response on that post. Yeah, so that has been great. Yeah.
Thank you for sharing your story, Sonam. It's incredible. Thank you so much.